Dear students, we welcome you on this platform to learn and understand in a better way. Today, we are going to learn about the chapter Quadratic Equation. So, before we learn quadratic equation, let us know the weightage in our board exam. Weightage, number of question is 2. And you will get it for 8 marks. 2 questions for 8 marks you will get. So, in this 2 questions again is divided into 2 parts. One is, the question is based on numerical coefficients. Numerical question, finding the values all. Then the second part is solving word problems. That is, you have to frame the quadratic equation and then you have to solve it. So, this is based on the weightage of your board exam. Now, let us get into inside the chapter. You'll see what is quadratic equation. An equation of the form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. An equation of the form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a, b, c are real numbers. That is, coefficient of x squared, coefficient of x and constant term are real numbers and a should not be equal to 0. Why a should not be equal to 0? When a becomes 0, the x squared term will become 0. So, we will have the polynomial bx plus c, the linear polynomial. So, a quadratic equation is of the form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where the coefficient of x squared, x constant term, a, b, c are real numbers and a is not equal to 0. Let us see few examples. X squared minus 7x plus 12 is a quadratic in x. 5a squared plus 3a plus 9 equal to 0 is a quadratic in a. Then the polynomial x plus 1 by x is 5 by 2. If we consider on the cross multiplication of taking LCM, you will get x squared plus 1 is equal to 5 by 2. On cross multiplying, 2x squared plus 2 minus 5x equal to 0 is a quadratic equation. So we can see the polynomial with the degree 2 with the single variable, we call it as quadratic equation. Now, let's learn about roots of quadratic equation. What is roots of quadratic equation? When we substitute a value alpha in ax squared plus bx plus c, the equation reduces to 0. That is, when I substitute x is equal to alpha, a into alpha squared plus b into alpha plus c is equal to 0. Then we call it as roots of quadratic equation. Based on this, you will get a sum like, show that x is equal to 4 is a root of x squared minus x minus 12 equal to 0. So, you'll have a question, show that x is equal to 4 is a root of x squared minus x minus 12 equal to 0. So, how we are going to find the solution? We will substitute x is equal to 4 in x squared minus x minus 12. So, when I consider the LHS part of the given quadratic, x squared minus x minus 12, I'll have 4 squared minus 4 minus 12, which is 16 minus 4 minus 12, which I can write as 12 minus 12, 0 RHS. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. So, x is equal to 4 is a root of given equation. So, we will make now, show that x is equal to 4 is a root of x squared minus x minus 12 equal to 0. We substitute the values, given x value in the given quadratic equation and check LHS is equal to RHS. If both are same, that is both are become equal to 0, then we say it is a root of the equation. If you get some values on LHS and RHS is 0, if it is not equal, then we say it is not a root of given equation.
Now, let us learn, what do you mean by solution set? The set of elements representing the roots of the quadratic equation is called solution set. We learned before what we mean by roots. Roots means when we substitute that value in the given quadratic, it will be reduced to zero. So the values which we make the quadratic to zero, we call that values our solution set. Next we have zero product rule. Let A and B be any two real numbers. Then if the product of A into B, if it becomes zero, we know either A should be 0 or B should be 0. This is called zero product rule. So, now with an example, we see how we are going to get a solution set using a zero product rule. Consider 3x squared plus 10x is equal to 25, which we make it into the general form of quadratic. 3x squared plus 10x minus 25 will become 0. Now we factorize this. This we learn from 7th and 8th standard onwards by splitting the middle term. So first we multiply the coefficient of x squared with the constant term, which gives you 3 into minus 25 is minus 75. Now we simplify this minus 75 into two factors in such a way the product should give us a constant term, the sum should give us the middle term. So we find 15 and 5 gives you 75. At the same time, plus 15 minus 5 gives you the middle term 10x. So we split the middle term in such a way 3x squared plus 15x minus 5x minus 25 is equal to 0. Now, how to factorize this? We will split the 4 terms into first 2 terms and the next 2 terms we will group it. In the first 2 terms, we see 3x is common. So we get x plus 5 inside the bracket. You check now, 3x into x, 3x squared, 3x into 5, 15x. Now, we should get the same x plus 5 as a common factor for the next step. So we write that x plus 5 in that other bracket. So we see now what is left off in that last two terms, minus 5. Let us check now. Minus 5 into x minus 5x minus 5 into 5 is minus 25. So now we see in this step x plus 5 is a common factor. So when we take it out, we have 3x minus 5 is equal to 0. Now, we use our zero product rule. X plus 5 into 3x minus 5, 0 gives either x plus 5 is 0 or 3x minus 5 should be 0. This is called a zero product rule. From this, we get x values to be minus 5 or 5 by 3. So, this x is equal to minus 5 and 5 by 3, we call it as solution set. So, we did the solution set using zero product rule. So let us solve one more sum. Solve x squared equal to 3x. Same way, similarly, we make it into a general quadratic. X squared minus 3x is equal to 0. We see x is common in both the term. X into x minus 3 is equal to 0, which gives us a zero product rule. Gives x is equal to 0 or x is equal to 3. So our solution set is 0, 3. So, we say the solution set using zero product rule, what we are getting are roots of the given quadratic equation. Now, let us solve a quadratic with some conditions given. For example, the sum is now 9x squared minus 22x plus 8 is equal to 0, where x belongs to natural number and the second one is x belongs to q. Q is what? Rational number. First, we consider the quadratic 9x squared minus 22x plus 8 equal to 0. We simplify using our zero product rule and get a solution set. So, we multiply the coefficient of x squared with the constant term 72 and split it into two factors that we get 18 4s are 72. At the same time, minus 18 and minus 4 gives you the middle term. So, when we simplify now, I can rewrite this as 9x squared minus 18x minus 4x plus 8 equal to 0. We consider, we group the first two terms and the last two terms. In the first two terms, we find 9x is common. So, we have x minus 2. Check it out now. 9x into x, 9x squared. 9x into minus 2 is minus 18x. Now, we should get the same x minus 2 in the other part. So, that what you should get here? Minus 4. We will check it out. Minus 4 into x minus 4. Minus 4 into minus 2 plus 8 is equal to 0. In this, we can see x minus 2. X minus 2 is common. We will take it out. So, what is to be grouped? 9x minus 4 is equal to 0. So, this gives us, comes under the product rule. 0 product rule, which says either x minus 2 is equal to 0 or 9x minus 4 is equal to 0. So, which says x minus 2 is equal to 0 or 9x minus 4 equal to 0. Gives us x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 4 by 9. On simplification, we get it as 2 by 3. X is equal to 4 by 9 or 2 by 3. Now, what is our first condition? X should belong to natural number. So, we consider, therefore, 2 belongs to natural number. And 4 by 9 does not belong to natural number. So, solution set. So, solution set is equal to, here what we will get? 2. In the second part, when x belongs to rational number, you know, 2 does not belong to rational number, but 4 by 9 belongs to rational number. Therefore, solution set 4 by 9, which we can write as 2 by 3. Solution set 4 by 9 or 2 by 3. Now, let us learn how to solve the problem, the roots when the solutions are given and the two variables to find in the given quadratic equation. If 2 by 3 and 1 are the solutions of the equation mx squared plus nx plus 6 is equal to 0, find the values of m and n. This is our question. In this question, they have given clearly 2 by 3 and 1 are solutions. That means when we substitute these values in the place of x in the given quadratic, mx squared plus nx plus 6 is equal to 0, we get the equations like by substituting x is equal to 2 by 3 in mx squared plus nx plus 6 is equal to 0, x value is 2 by 3. So we can simplify by taking the powers and taking the LCM and we get 4m plus 6n plus 54 equal to 0. Make it as equation 1. Now, when we substitute x is equal to 1 in mx squared plus nx plus 6 is equal to 0 in the given quadratic, we get m1 squared plus n1 plus 6 is equal to 0 is our second equation. Now, we can see this is a two linear equation in two variable. 4m plus 6n 54 is 0, m plus n plus 6 is equal to 0. So, we will solve this two equation using the method of linear equation in two variable, any one of the method. Now, in this sum, I am going to use substitution method. Since the variable has a coefficient 1, so 4m plus 6n is equal to minus 54, m plus n is equal to minus 6, are our two equation. From the second equation, I can get m is equal to minus 6 minus n by substituting this value in the first equation. So, I get 4m plus 6n is minus 54 is our first equation. In that m value 4 into minus 6 minus n plus 6n is minus 54. When we remove the bracket, 4 into minus 6 minus 24, 4 into minus n minus 4n plus 6n is equal to minus 54. Now, like term simplification, we get minus 4n plus 6n is 2n. Minus 24, take it to the other side as plus 24, I get it as minus 30. So, n is equal to 15. Substitute this n value In either one of the equation, what we have got, 1 or 2, we get m is equal to 9. So, in this sum, we saw any two roots like 2 by 3 and 1 solutions are given. And in the quadratic, if you have a coefficient of x squared and x have to be find, you have to substitute and simplify into the linear equation in two variable and solve it. Now, based on today's class, we will solve some sums considering it as assignment. The first question, which of the following equations are quadratic? 3x plus 3x minus 1 the whole squared is 5 into x plus 8. So, you reduce the identity and here you should remove the bracket and bring everything on one side and make it into general form of quadratic and check whether it is quadratic or not. The next sum, 5x squared minus 8x is equal to 6x minus 21. Group all the terms to LHS part and like terms you simplify and check whether you get quadratic or not. Third sum, x minus 4 into 3x plus 1 is equal to 3x minus 1 into x plus 2. You can use the product x plus a into x plus b and RHS is also x plus a into x plus b. Use the identity, simplify all the terms to LHS part, make it to the general form of quadratic and check. The next, x squared plus 5x minus 5 is equal to x minus 3 the whole squared. Here you can see this is of the identity a minus b the whole squared. Expand and simplify and bring all the terms to LHS. Cancel the like terms, subtract the like terms and simplify to the general form of quadratic and check. The next, 7x cubed minus 2x squared plus 10 is equal to 2x minus 5 the whole squared. Here also you can expand a minus b the whole squared identity. Simplify and check. Then x minus 1 the whole squared plus x plus 2 the whole squared plus 3 into x plus 1 equal to 0. Here you can use the identity a minus b whole squared. Here a plus b the whole squared. Remove the bracket and simplify the like terms and check whether it form a quadratic or not. Then next, if x is equal to 5 is a solution of x squared minus 2x minus 15 equal to 0. So, put the values of x is equal to 5 in the quadratic and see LHS equal to RHS. Similarly, the next sum x is equal to minus 3 is a solution of 2x squared minus 7x plus 9 equal to 0. Substitute the value of x and check LHS equal to RHS. You get the same that LHS equal to 0, RHS is also 0 given 0. Then it forms a solution. If you put a numerical equal to 0, it is not a solution. Then next, if root of 2 pi by 3, if root of 2 by 3 is a solution of 3x squared plus mx plus 2 equal to 0, find the value of m. Here, they have given directly it is a solution. So, when you substitute this value and make it equal to 0 value, which we will do like our remainder theorem, we find the value of m. Same way we have to substitute and do it. Next, if 3 and minus 3 are the solutions of ax squared plus bx minus 9 equal to 0, find the values of a and b. So first we will substitute the 3. We get a linear polynomial with a linear equation. And when you substitute minus 3 in the x value and you get the linear equation in two variable, solve both the linear equations and find the value of a and b. So, hope you have understood this class and let's see with a new topic of quadratic equation tomorrow. Thank you.